county to the other, using helicopters. We are hearing even most of them have bought Boeings and aeroplanes to make them move from one country to the other. Lakini this is a ground team. Kwa hivyo tumesema ground team, lazima tuongee maneno ambayo iko ground. Kwa hivyo ukituona hapa, tukiwa pamoja, we are youthful, independent thinkers, we are the voices of the common wananchi, because the other team that was calling themselves the hustlers have now migrated from being hustlers to sky teams. Kazi yao ni ku patronize the sky. From one country to the other, flying with the helicopters, and they know nothing about machinery. That is why they have the audacity of passing punitive and oppressive bills and policies without caring the status of the economy and the livelihood of our people. So, ladies and gentlemen, members of the press, I welcome you on behalf of this team to the one and the premier presser from the youthful, intelligent voice of the common wananchi, the ground team. What can you have to hear my comment on the ground team? The ground team is in charge. And therefore, we are here to air our concerns concerning various issues that are touching the common wananchi. And these are the issues that we have listened to our people. We have been following issues, and we feel that this is the right time for us to air our concerns. I don't know whether I should start with the first concern, because I feel that if we do not speak now that the skies are giving us rains, and farmers from Trans-Nzoia, from Busia, from all over Kenya, including Kiambu, Meru, farmers are agonizing over the insensitive way of enabling them to produce from their farms or from their fields. The president has been very vocal talking about subsidized seeds and subsidized fertilizers. But to our utter shock, the fertilizer that is out there being sold as subsidized fertilizer from outlets from National Cereals and Produce Board. And in this case, I'm talking about the fertilizer that the farmers are receiving messages on their phone that they qualify for subsidy program. It is adulterated fertilizer. The seeds that are available are fake seeds. And we are the farmers' voice, and we must call out the minister in charge of agriculture. The minister has appeared on television and on newspapers denying that there is no fake fertilizer. Yet, we are witnessing this kind of fertilizer every day. Yesterday, I was presented with 5 bags of fertilizer that is purported to be fertilizer, but it is fake stones mixed with Danke's poo. Danke's poo is the waste from the Danke. Danke's poo mixed with the stones, and it is being sold as subsidized fertilizer. We must call out this mess. The government has become so insensitive to the extent that now they are calling farmers. This is something that we want to see serious arrests. We want to know who is behind this scam. We want to know where did the fertilizer that was supposed to be real fertilizer go, and who is behind this serious, massive scam of taking advantage of our old and elderly farmers in our villages. This must stop. And every farmer who has been conned must be reversed their money. Every farmer who has been sold to fake seeds must be compensated by the government. It is in line with the Kenyan constitution, the right to protection of property, that we are here speaking, so that we can make sure that the government follows and obeys the rule of law and provide the Kenyan farmers with what they are supposed to be given. So we want to know, how much of that fertilizer, in terms of quantity, has been released into our villages? Because we are seeing 5 bags here, 10 bags here, 5 bags there. We want to see data from the Ministry of Agriculture. And the Minister of Agriculture, Bwana Linturi, must come out now and attack this issue, arrest this issue, and we want to see serious arrest being done by the ministry, by the government, and by the Ministry of Interior. This issue of conmanship must stop. Our farmers must be protected. Thank you very much.
Asanteni sana. As Mheshimiwa Wamuchomba stated, team that will be on the ground. This is a team that will voice the that will echo the voice of the voiceless, that will fight for the inherent and inalienable interests and rights of Kenyan citizens everywhere, wherever they are, in all the 8 regions. This is a team that comprises of youthful leadership, the generational change. And the team here, we have Mheshimiwa Caleb Amisi, all the way representing the Western region and the youth in the country, all the way from Saboti constituency. We have Mheshimiwa Wamuchomba Gathoni representing the Central region. We have Mheshimiwa Charles Nguna, CNN, representing the Eastern region. We have Mheshimiwa Amos Mwago, representing from Starehe constituency, representing Nairobi and the youth in the nation. We have Mheshimiwa Catherine Omanyo, all the way from Busia, the Busia women representative, representing Western region and also the youth in this nation. And we have also our leader, Mheshimiwa Mark Mwenje, who is also from Nairobi, and Kasi, and also representing Nairobi and the interest of the youth in this nation. And we have myself, representing also Nairobi and the youth in this nation. And therefore, we have issues that we will be addressing from time to time. And this is the team that is going to give direction in this country, because we have seen there's a little bit of laxity in opposition. And therefore, this team will take its rightful place to ensure that the interests of Kenyans, very objectively, are fought for. Not limited to holding rallies to discuss the plight and the issues affecting Kenyans. Not limited to calling for maandamanos, regional maandamanos, in every county, in every constituency, in every ward. And these maandamanos will better be imagined than experienced. And today we are here to talk about various issues. After that, we will be telling you a timetable on how we'll be moving as members of the press, because we want you to be part of us. And the first issue that we want to talk about is the issue of health. Mheshimiwa Wamuchomba has talked about the issue of fertilizers and the plight of farmers in various parts of this country. All the members of parliament here will talk about different issues. I want to talk about the issue of the health crisis. Right now, doctors are striking, and this is their 14th day into their strike. We don't want the government to relax, to let the doctors strike for over 100 days that happened between the year 2016 and 2017. There was a CBA, a collective bargain agreement, that was signed between the government and the doctors. And it entailed, number one, that the doctors be paid their arrears owned by the government. Up to now, the doctors in this country are owned some money by the government. Number two, that the interns, for the past 1 year, doctors who have trained, taken 6 years to train, and every year a doctor is trained with an average of around 600,000 Kenya shillings, which comes to around 3.6 million Kenya shillings. Then, after finishing your degree, you are not deployed anywhere. That is so wrong, and this is the first time this government, Ruto's government, is doing this. Number three, that the interns who have been deployed, who are employed already, the government has decided to deduct 91% of their salary. We want the government to move with speed and pay these doctors these amounts of money. President Ruto, instead of moving around in this country, should sit down, because what is so important and urgent is the interest of Kenyans. And these Kenyans who are in hospital are dying. Patients who are in hospital are not getting proper medical care. Why? Because of the strike caused by the doctors. Therefore, the president should not assign this duty. Even the CS, Cabinet Secretary for Health, who has proven to be very incompetent. Very incompetent, talking in rallies anyhow, talking in funerals, and we want that CS to step aside, and we will bring an impeachment motion against the CS for health. We want the president himself to call for a meeting with KMPDU, the leaders who are representing the interests of doctors in this country, and resolve this crisis within a week. Failure to which, we will announce our next course of action. We will call the media and announce the next course of action. Because our people are dying in hospitals. Imagine patients who are being taken to hospitals. Imagine Kenyans who are being taken to hospitals. They can't get any access to any doctor to help them with their various ailments. Therefore, we demand, we don't want to request. Ruto, you say you would. In fact, from the time you were elected, There's nothing that you've done that is necessary. Everything you are doing is just causing havoc, causing pandemonium, causing a lot of tension in this country. And I want to tell you that if you don't move with speed, we will move with speed. And this is a new team, the young blood, the fresh breath, that is going to breathe breath into the dry bones of the problems facing Kenyans. Lastly, on the Haiti issue, the United States of America did state clearly at the Congress, they did mention that Ruto's interest is about making money in this country, that Ruto is just interested in making the 13 billion Kenya shillings and is not interested on the humanitarian part of taking care of interest of Kenyans. If you take these police officers who are fathers, who are children of others, who are relatives and friends of Kenyans, these people are going to be killed. We were being informed that at least 20,000 police officers should be deployed, at least 20,000 should be deployed in a hit. Why do we want to take 1,000 officers? And these 1,000 officers are going to die. And we say, ukienda Haiti, utakuwa maiti. For even the police officers, it is a high time. You must reject these orders. You cannot take everything. Thank you very much. Let me invite Caleb Amisi to say one.
Yeah, thank you. I'll be brief so that I allow my colleagues to also say something. First and foremost, this is a generational change. Every generation in this country, from the time of colonialism, from the fight for multipartism, from the fight for promulgation of the new constitution, and to the fight for devolution, every generation has had a chance to rise up and do what needed to be done. We are now called upon as a generation to rise up and do what needs to be done. We fought democracy, we fought new constitution, we fought multipartism. Now it's time for economic emancipation. This is the duty of our generation. And we are here to announce that there is a new awakening. The young, the energetic, the charismatic, the revolutionary have arisen. And it's not going to be business as usual on the street. We are going to rise up and take up our duty, our cardinal duty to protect and preserve the interests of the local Mwananchi. On the issue of the health, it has been my proposal, even during the BBI and even the NADCO report, that we must have a health service commission. Just the way we have a teacher service commission, we no longer hear about teacher strike. You need to ask yourself, why don't we have teacher strike that used to be a perennial menace in this republic? It's because we had a body that has a potential of interacting with the necessary government agencies to solve their issues. We need to have a health service commission that will take care of the overall problems of the health sector, whether it is from the nurses, the doctors' interest, or the overall status of our health system. And the IT system, I'm an international student, of master's student. And I can tell you, there is no any iota of wisdom in the IT mission. There is no bilateral ties between Kenya and Haiti. There is no embassy of Kenyan in Haiti. There is no Haitian embassy here in Kenya. There is absolutely no ties between Kenya and Haiti. We must be told in white and black what was the necessity of Kenya advancing towards Haiti. That is a UN problem. It is not a Kenyan problem. It is not a bilateral ties problem. It is not a country-to-country problem. Haiti is an internal matter. And under the UN Charter, no any nation on earth has the prerogative, the derogation, to interfere with the internal affairs of another country. That is the interest and the mandate of the UN, not the Kenyan interest. So from the first time, we must be told what is the status of the Haiti mission, owing to the fact that the Congress have pronounced themselves against funding of this mission from the Biden administration. Thank you very much. I'll give an opportunity to my colleagues here to also say something. Then we'll allow you guys to ask us a question.
Hey, I used to hear Ruth say he must finish the dynasty. Now he has become himself a dynasty. If I go back to his statement, even him, because he's a dynasty, he will be finished. You cannot be saying this dynasty must be finished. I bet you are admiring to him. Everything that he has done or promised, it's just like a short-lived dinner party anecdote. Immediately you are done with it, you go sleep, wake up to your problems. Kenyans are suffering. Everything that Ruto is doing, selling our properties, treating Kenyan properties like personal property, selling a national bank, he's all over Mombasa Port, Kenya Seed, everything that he's been selling. My question is, how much is he saving for the future generation? We demand that 10% of every sale he has done, 10%, and every profit, the 10% must be saved for future generation. Otherwise, the way he's running this nation, he's running like the way he does the sky team. You know now he's leading the sky team, flying blue. We do not want anything to do with his promises. Kenyans must take charge of their lives starting today and do what will make their lives better. Because if you come to farmers, even the fertilizer that is being sold today is poison to the ground, poison to the products. Cannot make it, the farmers get the yields they need to get. I used to learn agriculture. It was our backbone, I think something like that. The backbone of our nation. Now, if you go to the backbone of the nation and interfere with it, how do you expect to run a nation that is full of graves? Is he planning to bury people? Because now if we will not have enough food, where will we run to? If we cannot produce even our own, where do we run to? Because a proper leader foresees some things and has a plan to back to. What has he done since he had that now the fertilizer that was supplied was fake? Who supplied the fertilizer? Who won the tender? Why don't we see these people explain to us why this fertilizer is chop? Some of this fertilizer is chop. It's not even stones. And some fake poo. We don't know where they are getting the poo from. We want these people to supply this fake fertilizer already behind bars. Because we cannot be, every day is just something going wrong in Ruto's offices. So whoever is sitting, wherever they are sitting, those offices, agriculture department, people dealing with health, everything is off. We need changes and changes, and we are going to steer ahead the changes that Kenya is wanting.
Government is so vicious about. When it comes to passing the punitive finance bill, we saw what transpired